We are joined by BRS spokesperson M. Krishank. Telangana cabinet has taken a decision to call Sonia Gandhi to Telangana, felicitate her on the occasion of formation of Telangana state. So what do you have to say to this?
Good to know that the Congress has realized finally after 10 years when Telangana state celebrates a decade of its formation. Now finally Congress party thinks that they should actually celebrate. Why? Probably because they are in power. But you know, Telangana is such an emotion that even if you are in power or not in power, you should celebrate it. But Congress never celebrated, June 2nd as Telangana Formation Day. And most importantly, they want to felicitate their Soniamma. The same Soniamma whom Chief Minister Revanth Reddy ji called a murderer, Balidevata, that because of her, 1200 innocent Telangana youth committed suicide. Well, now they want to felicitate her. But you know what? What should actually Telangana government or the Congress government should celebrate? Celebrate the whole inception of Telangana and how Telangana has been a model to the country. Because at one end, politically, Revanth Reddy ji has been defaming Telangana state, the performance of Telangana state. Initially, when they formed the government, they started speaking about debts. You know, India has a lot of debt under Modi ji. Many states have debts. Telangana is nowhere in the top 20-25 states also. But you know, for politics, Revanth Reddy ji blamed. Irrigation project. We have at a huge pace, we've done irrigation projects. But the same project which has been a boon for the irrigation and for drinking water, that has been defamed by the Congress government. Mission Bhagiratha kind of schemes. I mean, drinking water, electricity. So the whole a narrative by Revanth Reddy's government has brought Telangana to a shame, and that is why we have lost a formulae. We have lost Corning, which wanted to invest 1000 crores here, and now L&T also wants to move away from here. And yesterday our working president KTR Garu also has mentioned that how Tech Mahindra wants to leave Warangal. So the whole point the Congress party should realize that KCRG's government or Telangana's first government has done great work. Try to celebrate it. Try to felicitate all the assets which we have built. Instead, you would want to show Telangana in a bad light. And one more important thing is, Madam Gandhi is coming. She is the same one who read out huge list of guarantees that the Congress would, do if they come in power. But what happened? Now, people are talking about the U-turn of the promises of Congress government. Be it the 4,000 rupees for the unemployed youth, be it 15,000 Raitu Bharosa for farmers, the rupees 500 bonus for paddy in the same cabinet meeting yesterday, they've taken a U-turn. Because in the Kharif season, we get broken rice, parboiled rice and the mota chawal. We don't get the fine rice. But now they've kept all rules and regulations and restrictions. So the whole thing is, Congress is a U-turn government.
Now, here what the Congress minister, the Telangana cabinet minister has stated is that KCR government was only possible because Sonia Gandhi had, given a separate state of Telangana, the Raitu Bandhu, all the schemes that were bought during the KCR regime are only the credit must be given to Sonia Gandhi, because if she wouldn't give Telangana, then this wouldn't happen.
Well, only because KCRG started a political party exclusively for Telangana state, the Congress had no choice but to include the Telangana agenda in the common minimum program. And what did Congress do? Justice Sri Krishna committee, even before that, Pranab Mukherjee committee, Chidambaram committee, announcement, took it back. It was the people of Telangana on the call of KCRG for a fast and to death. Whole of people, keeping all their agendas aside, came and agitated. Where was Mr. Revanth Reddy then? Wasn't he the man who took a rifle against the Telangana youth? Today they are forgetting history, but people of Telangana haven't forgotten history. They cannot, and this government, Congress government, because Mr. Revanth Reddy has claimed that he wants to erase the history of KCR. Is that possible? Yes, KCRG in the assembly has given credit to Mrs. Gandhi, to late Srimati Sushma Swaraj ji and all the political parties who have supported and made it possible, the bill passing in the parliament. But who took the initiative? Now, if Congress wants to call Sonia Gandhi ji Sonia Amma, why shouldn't people of Telangana call KCR ji as, you know, the Bapu of Telangana? What's wrong in it? If not for him, no one from the Congress took initiative. There were people who took U-turns then also for their posts. And Revanth Reddy Garu also was in a political party which was against Telangana, which gave letters against Telangana. So we are not forgetting history, and at the same time, we will not allow Congress party to erase the history and to erase KCR from the history of Telangana. It is not possible at all. You cannot, you know, we've seen how initially the Congress leaders tried to smudge away the name on foundation stones, the name of KCRG on the foundation stones. But was it possible? They would try to do such kind of tamasha. But KCR is in the history of Telangana, and history cannot be erased by the Congress party or Revanth Reddy ji.
Thank you so much for speaking with us. So this was the BRS spokesperson M. Krishang with camera person Damodar Abdul Bashir, Hyderabad.